It is a crime that dominated the headlines in August 2022 as reports of drink spiking, a criminal act where somebody puts alcohol or drugs into another person's drink without their knowledge, became all too common. Now reports of those criminal incidents, locally referred to as mchele, have spread beyond Nairobi's borders, with revelers from cities such as Nakuru now reporting the prevalence of such tactics. And as Marianne Nyambura now reports, the drink spiking syndicate has amongst its members bartenders at high-end clubs and rogue pharmacists colluding with the gangs to rob innocent revelers.
The night of Saturday, 17th September 2022, is a night this middle-aged man who sought anonymity will live to remember. To conceal his identity, let's refer to him as Tom. It all started when Tom and his group of friends casually decided to visit an entertainment venue in Nakuru town that night. A few drinks in and four visitors came knocking at their table.
And we were drinking, we were like around 12, 15 people. So we were drinking. Then later on, the waiter came and requested me if I can pay my bill. Then I told the waiter that yes, I can pay the bill. Then he told me that I paid the bill. He insisted, of which I paid the bill. I don't know the reason why he was insisting. I paid the bill. After paying the bill, he requested if I can give him my phone so that he check on, he wanted to write a code. So I gave out my phone, he wrote a code, and after that, I think the waiter saw the balance I had. So from there, he went and came back with some people. There were like around two ladies and two guys. Then he brought the ladies, and he gave a space where we were sitting.
Tom and his friends did not suspect any ill intentions from the four who joined in merrymaking. But that is when the rain began beating he and his friends.
Feeling uneasy because the alcohol was not the way we were. It was not tasting the way we were doing it before. So one of us decided to go to the car because I was feeling strange. Another person left. So I was with my friend, being that me, I was a visitor there. I was with my friend because I couldn't move or go because I was going to spend on my friend's house. So my friend was playing pool and coming back to the table. So by the time I started feeling weird, then I decided to tell my friend.
3 months after the horrific ordeal, Tom and some of his friends are still trying to piece together the events of that night. What is undeniable is that they had fallen victim to a drink-spiking gang. Tom had a near-death experience, as the drug that was secretly administered to him took 14 hours to wear off from his body. He also lost 580,000 shillings.
My phone and decided to told me to give my M-Pesa pin, of which he sent money to Justin Mogori. Then another number called Naliaka. So after doing that, they took my phones. They took I had three phones. They took the three phones. Then after that, they took my watch. I had a smartwatch, which is 30K. They took that smartwatch of mine, and they withdrew all the money that I had in my M-Pesa account and the money that I had in my account as well. Then at the same time, they decided to fuliza from my phone. Then they did Mshwari, then they did M-Pesa, KCB M-Pesa. So they took a lot of money from me. They took everything that they took from me was worth 580,000.
In Nakuru, we meet another victim who doesn't want his identity revealed. So let's call him Brian. Brian learned a tough lesson after a night of merrymaking in October this year that turned out to be a costly affair. He was to be the designated driver amongst his friends, and so he kept off alcohol. But the gang still did the unthinkable.
Kia loss of memory and all that. I've not been drinking. What's up? Because I was doing water and energy drink. I don't remember. I think I lose memory at some point. Siku kumbuka ni nini ilikuwa inaendelea. Venye niliamka nilijipata kwa nyumba. That was around 11, considering I left the club at around 4 in the morning. So venye niliamka nikiangalia everything in the house is scattered. Vitu kila kitu iko everywhere. Nikitafuta simu, sioni simu, and all that. Alikuwa amejaribu kifungu ya gari, alikuwa amejaribu kutoka nayo. The good thing is nilikuwa nimeseparate and all that. Nilikuwa nimeseparate the keys. So akuweza kumanage kupata hiyo kifungu. I think that's why I still have the car.
Cases of innocent travelers targeted in high-end clubs by these drink-spiking gangs within Nakuru have been on an upward trend in recent months. But for male revelers who avoid the opposite gender, thinking that they are safer that way might soon be surprised to realize that even your newly befriended male drinking partner might also be up to no good. Collins, who relocated to Nakuru a year ago, went clubbing all alone. He made a friend at the nightclub, only to realize later on that the man had turned on him.
Nilitoka on Saturday jioni, kuenda kunywa drink hivi kidogo. Sasa mahali nilikuwa nakunywa, kulikuwa na mwingine hapo pia alikuwa nakunywa yake kidogo. Tukaanza kupiga story kwa sababu nilikuwa peke yangu. Ambapo baadaye nilizidiwa, akachukua simu zangu, akaweza kulipa bills bila consent yangu. Ambapo alinipeleka hadi town, akanipeleka tena klabu ingine. Hapo ndio bouncer mwenye anafanya kwa hiyo klabu aliniona na kuulizia huyo jamaa kwamba sijawahi ona huyo jamaa huyo beshtangu akiwa hivyo.
This is intimated to Citizen TV that these drink spiking gangs usually prey on revelers who appear wealthy. Factors such as the vehicle one drives into the premises, the type of drink one orders, and how much money one spends at the club on that night are put into consideration before the gang strikes. The spiking business is not a one-man show, but an intricate syndicate that allegedly involves bar owners, bartenders, rogue elements in the pharmaceutical industry, and even security guards at resorts, all working in cahoots with the gang. Sources also revealed to Citizen TV that some commercial sex workers are part of the gang. And so we took a drive along the streets of Nakuru to establish the truth. Two commercial workers narrated to us how the drink spiking business emerged and has grown to become a multi-million shilling industry.
E deal, ushezagi ukiwa peke yako, unakutaga, unasheza pamoja na mawaita, haya na masoja wa gate. Juu kuna room zingine, uwezi kaingia na jamaa utoke peke yako. Huyu mwenye kumuuzia huyu waiter ni anakuambiaga enda kwa jamaa fulani, pini yake iko hivi na hivi na balance yake nimeona iko hivi na hivi. Enda uongee na yeye, bora ujue ya yangu. Sasa wewe ukienda kwa room, manake huyu unaweza kamwekea kwa ba ishindikane, inabidi umpembeleze, muende na yeye kwa room kukimuingiza box. Akiingia box, unaenda kwa room, kiingia na yeye kwa room, uwezi katoka juu room mingi siku hizi, uwezi katoka peke yako, inabidi utoke na mwenye umeingia na yeye. Sasa wewe ukifanya kazi yenye umefanya mpaka uone mwenye kukufungulia gate, umemwona zake. Aya, ikifika ni waiter mwenye alikupatia pin, umempakata zake. Daktari mwenyewe umempakata zake. Na yeye
hapa unakuaga na namba kama 4. Lakini kama 4 umeregister na namba different. Na ninaomba tu, naambia wenye wanapotezeka ID. ID yako ikipotea, enda kwa huduma center ama uende kwa polisi, useme ID yako imepotea. Manake sisi tukiokota ID yako, sisi tunaenda tunaregister nayo. Tukiregister nayo, tunapata namba na tunajiwekea pin. Tukijiwekea pin, ni hivyo. Namba yako itakuwa mteremko kwetu.
Those who fall victim report losing large amounts of money in a single night. Money that they would otherwise have if it were not for the drug spiking gang. Two doctors fell victim, million shillings and another 1.2 million. The son of a prominent politician from the Rift Valley region also reported being a victim in December 2022, losing at least 3 million shillings. However, the wheels of justice turn slowly for the victims.
Losing money in tunes of hundreds in a day, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of money to anyone. We have several cases which are already still pending in court, as you know. But you see these people, once they are taken to court, the following day they're asking for bond, they come out. And the next weekend in the next club, if they were here, and you know, because it's a big circuit. It operates between Nakuru, Nairobi, Kisumu, Eldoret. They keep on rotating wherever they can get money. So at times it's difficult to understand. Unashika mtu leo, ampeleka kotini, next weekend is out again, ako the same biashara.
Pharmacists say the Zolpidem drug should only be sold on prescription, but many rogue elements have infiltrated the industry and colluded with the Mchele gang to sell it as an over-the-counter drug. This tablet, as tiny as it looks, has a negative effect on the victim and could cause a fatality if taken in excess.
And it takes effect probably after an hour of use. That's why a lot of people who've been drugged, they always say they were lucid for an hour or so or 30 minutes, then they don't remember what happened. And in many instances, the people who are already using alcohol together with the drug, the effect kicks in a little bit faster and the effects of the drug are more exaggerated. Badala ya kulala masaa manane, you could sleep for much longer hours. And truth be told, at times they overdose you.
Nyoko na ugonjwa, ukimwekea, inaweza kamzidi nguvu. Kama watu wa sukari ukiwawekea, ni mbaya. Si mzuri. Juu ama watu hawa wanakuoga na pressure, si mzuri kuwawekea. Although, uwezi kajua manake.
At least 4 cases have been reported in Nakuru in the month of December. And police warn that revelers should be extra cautious as the multi-million shilling spiking business continues. Miriam Nyambura, Citizen TV, Nakuru.